After the bike inspection and charging back up to 100%, going out for a little ride today. Gonna ride up to Hanging Rock State Park here in North Carolina. It's about 20 miles away from my house. Showing 95 mile range and 20 miles to go. That'll be some nice curvy roads. Driving on this road, it had black ice all over it. We get to ride up Highway 66 going up to Hanging Rock, which is a nice curvy road. I've done a video with my Mini Cooper and on my Zero SR. Riding up 66. Guineas. Tells me about railroad crossings, but not Guinea crossings. Not much traffic out on a Wednesday. It's the thing about living out in the country. Is you come up on tractors. Working his tobacco fields. The tractor was going a little too slow. I couldn't feel the air through my jacket. That's Pilot Mountain, straight ahead there. And that's Sartown and Hanging Rocks to the right of it. And that's a field of tobacco to the left. Sartown Mountain, straight ahead, is where there's a lot of TV antennas and radio stations. No WXII is up there. The ham radio club I'm in, W4NC, they've got one of their repeater antennas up there on top of the mountain. And it covers a long ways. We'll be going by John Brown's little country store on the left here that has good sandwiches. They got a little deli in there. It's a good place to stop and get lunch. As a matter of fact, it's 11:30. Might have to go in and get a sandwich.
huge fields of tobacco. Looks like there are a lot of farmers in North Carolina have switched over to soybean or corn. They do the corn for the gasoline, for the ethanol. I get gas for my zero-turn mower and I get ethanol free. I used to hang glide off the top of Sourtown. But I am going to stop at John Brown's, get a sandwich and a drink, and I will be back.
So I just finished up a quick lunch here at John Brown's on Highway 66. Heading up to Hanging Rock. A bunch of people stop here to pick up their lunch. A nice little grill in there to do sandwiches and pizza. And we got about 9.8 miles left. Still got 93.5% range, and I know I'll regen quite a bit coming off the mountain, coming back down. We've got a small little mountain range here in the Piedmont. You got Pila Mountain, Sourtown, Hanging Rock, and then there's another one just to the other side of it. And it's starting to get just a little warm.
Ahead is Hanging Rock. We now have zip lines up here too. They're a little expensive. I guess they cost a lot of money to put the cables through the trees. Actually where I started the video on my Mini Cooper a long, long time ago on YouTube. Except back then it was a camera that only did 30 frames a second, so I had to speed it up so it looked like I was flying down this road. good toasted pimento cheese sandwich there at John Brown's. They do it on big Texas toast. All the fun begins, except I'm turning off of it to go to Hanging Rock. I've got another video posted up of me riding 66. We're going to be turning right just after this next curve. Actually taken, had a ZXR 400RR out of Japan. I took it up to Deals Gap, and I've had two of my Mini Coopers I took up there, up in the mountains of North Carolina on the Tennessee line. It's 312 curves in 11 miles, and it will wear you out. The motorcycle about 10 curves in. Straight. I haven't ever gone right before. Like both roads are headed the same direction, because that's Hanging Rock straight ahead. There's a smoke lookout tower way up there on the top, and to get up to it you go up a ton of rock steps. Stone wall. Regen down all these hills. they're staying at 93 mile range with all the regen. Nice fence. Number of buzzards flying overhead. Thinking they're looking for lunch too. Rain come through here yesterday, some quick thunderstorms. It's a little humid today. Hanging Rock's got camping, hiking, swimming, and we have goats. I have a dog chasing me. He probably likes to have a friend. I think this used to be a back entrance to Hanging Rock, and it's not anymore.
I can hear the road just over the ridge. But when it's gravel road and it says do not enter, that's somebody's private road now. So I'm going to go out here and turn right. At least I know where this road is now if I ever want to come on it. This road. Now, why these cars are going so slow, I am not sure. I guess they're just not in a hurry. There's a traffic jam coming out of Hanging Rock. Turning right because I am going to Hanging Rock. It runs you back down to Danbury down by the river. There's a number of parks there too. Maybe we'll take a quick break. And then we have one park here over in Clemens called Tanglewood. They don't allow motorcycles in there because of the horses, but my motorcycle's quiet. Gone camping up here a number of times. In the mornings you see a lot of deer and wild turkey and feel the air getting a little cooler. Sure, there'll be a lot of people camping up here. I know schools are getting ready to start back.
Still at 93.7 miles range. Back in high school, we used to come up here almost every weekend. There's a number of waterfalls up here. Should be the campground down to the right. And that's the visitor center over there. And we'll be coming up to the lake here. I don't know if they've already closed the swim. No, I see lifeguards out there. They've got canoes and rowboats. And swimming. See quite a few cars and buses up here in the parking lot. Be a fun field trip from school. Come up to Hanging Rock and have a picnic. Cabarrus County. On the weekends, these parking lots are packed. Down to 90.6. Let's see what I can get back up to. Smoke lookout tower's up on the other ridge over there, and it takes a while to hack up there.
it is a weekday. Might not be a lot of people camping. You actually have to call up here and make a reservation now. You used to just be able to show up and have your camping stuff and you were good. There's a little mini amphitheater up here where they do little nature talks, and you can actually rent cabins, which is off to the right there. I haven't seen any tents yet. There's one. A camper. Or the camp host. That's their little amphitheater. They talk about wildlife and they do have bathhouses here to take showers. And their campsites are pretty nice. They put in these little bermed up sand pads so you're not sleeping on all the roots and rocks. See a few little campers in here. I've always come in here and gone tent camping. Weekends, you come through here and there's every spot full. It's one of the bathhouses over there. Hanging Rocks, just north of Winston-Salem. That had an R flipped out on it. I think that's when they do the reservations on them. I'm sure people are probably wondering why they don't hear a loud motorcycle. the mobile hospital I volunteer with, they have training up here. As a matter of fact, I think it was when it was snowing. They'll work with a bunch of the EMS and fire, volunteer fire departments up here. We just got back from West Virginia from taking down a bunch of Western shelters we loaned out to the World Scout Jamboree for the couple weeks they were up there in Glen Jean, West Virginia. Well, 94.1 miles, 94.2. That's what I left John Brown's with. Actually, I left John Brown's with 93. Going swimming. I know there's I think the company's in England. They make a small tent for motorcycles that actually uses your motorcycle as one of the supports for the shelter. They put this big parking lot in, and there's a visitor center over there on the other side. Last time I came up here, they had the main trail up to the top closed. The trails over to the waterfalls were closed. But the main trail going up was open. These trails here go down to the waterfalls. It looks like they got the parking lot closed. They had some storms come through up here, like I did down at my house. There was probably a bunch of trees down. We'll see what we get at the bottom. Up to 99.2. 101.4. Doesn't take long. I do have to roll on the throttle a little. I can do it just a little bit, and it pretty much evens out between the regen and the usage. Temperature's not too bad, it's still 106 Fahrenheit. I know I get up warmer than that when it's 98 and 99 degrees out riding. And I just hit 106.6 mile range. About 112.9. Showing 115.4 miles. The dog's not waiting for me. It's a little warmer down here. Altimeter up on the GPS.
I live out in the country, but this is country. It's dead quiet up here. Something about riding the zero when I'm coming through there, I can hear the cicadas and crickets, frogs. There's the farmhouse for that fence. Nice to live up here at the foot of the mountain. And still sitting with 112.4 miles. Interesting log church. It's that stone wall around. They must have had to clear all that out. there's Sour Town with all the antennas on top. And a big old field of tobacco. See quite a ways up here. Road that goes all the way up to those antennas. I've got a friend that puts salt down in the winter time, and he's got his back his salt truck all the way up to the gate. Horse trails, all horse and hiking, all over up here. Go the other direction, there's a sharp hairpin curve, goes down across the bridge and cuts back up to the right. My Mini Cooper, I had a G meter in it, and it was lowered and built for autocrossing. Pulled 1.1 G's through that corner. Carolina, you kind of learn this time of the year you have a 50-50 chance of showers. Was going, that was gonna work the tobacco fields. Strawberry farm this direction. Well, it's not just strawberries, they sell everything. straight. Saying 5.4 miles. And I'm at 96.3 miles. Gravel on it. almost home. A mile. Miles, and I think that's close to what I left the house with. Granted, I'm at 68%, but another safe ride. If y'all have any questions, just post them below. And y'all can come riding with me another time.